This is the Homestead Building Project Series. Today I'm going to be installing the casing around the doors, trimming out the doorways here on the back of the barn. And also, we're going to be building those doors, those sliding doors, so stay tuned. Hello, welcome back to Pine Meadows Hobby Farm. I'm your host, Jerry Hansen. I want to thank you guys for continuing to join me on this saga of rebuilding the barn from when it burnt down last Friday the 13th in April. So today I am building the casing around the doors, and I'll be trimming those out, and I'll also be fabricating the doors. And I got my building material, and so let's get started. And measure my header, which is 4.5 inches. And then we're gonna go 26 inches wide. And 72.25 inches high. Now we put the trim on. Now it's time to paint it. Okay, the painting's done. Now I just have to let it dry, but I've got the door casings in finally. I'm just gonna wait to do the trim around the door casings on the inside of the barn till later, because I have to do it all in an incremental order. So that would be a project for the inside of the barn, so stay tuned for that episode. Let's move on to the next step in this project, and I'm gonna take these boards that I purchased. They're all pre-cut to 6 foot. I bought them at 6 foot lengths, and the door is gonna be exactly 6 feet high. So we're gonna go ahead and fabricate the door. The 5 boards together comes out to be 27.5 inches wide, and that will be enough for my 27 inch wide door, or door opening. So now I need to cut 4 pieces of a couple 2x6s to get 27.5 inches. I need 4 of them. perfectly square. Okay, on this next step of building the door, I'm going to use these carriage bolts to make sure the door is nice and secure. I've got some washers and nuts, but I've got to countersink the nuts and then tap a hole all the way through the door to accommodate the carriage bolt. So I put a tape on as a depth guide, because that's how deep I want to drill each hole. So let's start that. Okay, I pre-marked my holes, and then we'll just start drilling. Now I'm going to swap out that paddle bit with this quarter inch drill bit to accommodate the carriage bolt. Before I put the hardware in, I want to be able to paint this, so let's get that done. Okay, I think the paint's dry enough. We're gonna go ahead and flip it over and do the other side before I do the hardware. It's time to put the hardware on. So I'm gonna put a carriage bolt through there, put a nut in my nut driver, and put a washer on top of that. And there it goes, it sits. Okay, I got all the carriage bolts in. And now I'm going to take my auger bit and drill two holes through this 2x6 header beam. And this is where I am installing the door hangers. So let's get those drilled. This is tricky. This is very tricky. Okay, now I got a washer. And then I've got two of these nuts, and that washer has a groove in it and it has some little holes. So we're going to position that where it needs to be, and we might end up having to screw it down. Maybe. Touch the other side. Now comes the leveling of the door. Yeah, I'm going to need to put a screw in that washer, because this washer has to hold its position. you know, put a screw in there to lock it, and then I got a sliding barn door. Much better. So I have the keeper guides on the bottom of the door to keep the animals from pushing out of the bottom of the door. Now that that's installed, the animals can't push the door open, but I still gotta put a stopper over here. So the hardware will keep the door from coming apart. Usually when I put a door together with just wood screws, they usually work themselves out and become loose after a while. But I'm also gonna add additional features to this door to help with it. So this isn't by any means the final door, but you get an idea on what my sliding door looks like. Awesome! Much better for my livestock. Well, that's it on the building projects here on the homestead on installing the sliding barn doors and fabricating the sliding barn doors. I'm your host, Jerry Hansen. This is Pine Meadows Hobby Farm. Please subscribe, leave a comment, and also smash that share button. It really helps our video channel greatly. Also share, hit the like. That's also nice, and also leaving your comments helps me be in touch with you and get a sense of what you guys are looking for as far as the channel goes. But trying to keep it real here, and we'll see you guys again in another video. Bye bye.